nice to see you again. So I'm just going to show you this quickly. That's your results from all your 6 tests. So the purpose of today is to just give you back your different all your 6 tests and give you some feedback to show you how you can improve. So I'm going to start with your sit and reach test first. So your result was 15 centimetres. That was like the average out of 3 goes. So from the normative data, you go into the category of good, so that's okay, but you can have room for improvement there. So the importance of having flexibility in any position in hockey is that it gives you good pliability and in the hamstring and the back. Due to being in a low position, to be able to cover the possession of the ball, this will over time put strain on your back, especially put strain on all muscles, like your hamstring and back, but mainly your back because obviously that lower position. So this will be a weakness because over time it will cause back injury, leading to you to come out of fitness for quite a long time, so that your cardio would go down. Also, if you would struggle to get down into that lower position, it would mean that you have to stand up higher. This will then mean that you'll have less control over the ball, and it could be easier for the opposition to take away the ball so they gain possession themselves. So the strengths of having good flexibility is that it will improve the range of movements around the joints. Therefore, you will be able to have quicker turns to change direction, because there will be less stress on the muscle and joints, because it will be more pliable, therefore further, you can push it further and there won't have any damage. So the way you can improve flexibility is following these principles. So how many times you would do it a week would be 5 times. The intensity would be low, just so you would just be stretching that muscle until you can feel it stretching itself. It depends how long the activity will take you. So like say if you're going to do some stretches, it can go over 10 minutes or more or less, just depends how long you want to work on it. And the type of training you're going to do is PNF. So this is short for proprioceptive neuromuscular facilitation, and they recommend to hold the stretch for about 8 to 10 seconds of stretch. Okay, so next we're going to move on to the hand grip dynamometer test. Your average result was 33, and by looking at the normative data, you are below average, and therefore this score will definitely need to be improved. So the reason why you need to improve is due to being a midfielder within hockey, you're always going to be pushing on your position as well, they'll be pressurising you. So therefore you need, when you're going for a tackle, the grip on the stick will have to be strong and firm. If you didn't, it would mean if someone was coming to tackle you, you may lose the ball because your stick would be easier to push around and it can fall out of your hands maybe. This would be a weakness in the game because the opposition would be able to get the ball and it could potentially lead to a goal if you're close to the D. The positives of proving your strength would be that you'll have a stronger hit, therefore it will benefit you if you're in the D, because it'll be able to have a powerful hit to clear the ball, then obviously it will go faster into the D and it could stop them like intercepting it. But it could also be hitting the ball down the pitch to another player, which is free. It could simply be taking a shot at goal. Having more strength behind the hit will make it harder for the defender to interfere, because the ball would be travelling at a faster speed and harder for the goalie to stop because the reaction time might be slower, therefore it won't be able to save it in time. So the way we can improve your strength is following this type of training. So 2 to 3 times a week, doing 4 to 8 reps with 4 to 5 sets. The time again is how long it takes you to complete it all. And then, so the type of training would be drop sets, which is going to the point of failure, or you could do negative training. So going on to the next test is vertical jump. Our results came out at 33, therefore this puts you in the category of average. The vertical jump shows power in your legs, so strength in the legs is needed in any sorts, but in hockey, due to running up and down the pitch, you will need strong legs. This will allow your muscles to continuously work throughout the game without getting fatigued. Therefore, this is going to be a positive, obviously, because you'll be working at a good level of performance. Being able to run up and down the pitch will ensure you are covering all areas of the pitch and help other teammates by running into space so then they can pass the ball to you. This will obviously improve the level of teamwork and the play game of play. Due to the vertical jump being explosive power, this could lead to a short corner taking place, and you have to be running back from the halfway line to help your defenders. So that sudden sprint will react like an explosive power. So due to it being average, you have a good level of it, but it can be improved. So by doing this training, so doing it 1 to 2 times a week, doing 2 to 4 reps within 1 to 2 sets, and then again until completion. Plyometrics is the main way you can build up your strength, power, and then like for example doing box jumps, so that will help improve it all. So the next one is the 1 minute press up test. So your results is an average you're getting, therefore there's room for improvement and build up more like of your muscular endurance in the arms. Having good muscular endurance in hockey is needed. This will help improve you to keep going through the whole game, and it will help to prevent fatigue from occurring. And the main place where you need good muscular strength for hockey is in the legs, but due to constantly running. But the test we did was for your arms, so we'll obviously talk about that more. So we need to have good levels of muscular endurance in the arm because we are constantly holding a stick. Even though there isn't a lot of weight, but there is still going to be that weight always going to be constantly in your arms. So if your arms start to get fatigued, during the match, this will mean that your hits will become like decreasing power, therefore they won't travel as far, meaning the opposition have more of an opportunity to get the ball in game session. So obviously then you will give your opposition the ball, and that can obviously again lead to a goal or whatever. So the way you can improve your muscular endurance is this training. So doing it frequency is the 2 to 3 times a week. Intensity is 10 reps within 4 to 5 sets. And then time is to complete and completion. So like when you finish, it doesn't matter how long it takes. And then type is supersets, trisets, which is working on a group of muscle, but different exercises. So you do 3 exercises in one group. The next test is 30 meter sprint. Your results was below average, therefore there is obviously an improvement to be made. And the reason you need to have speed in hockey is that when the opposition has the ball, being able to run towards them will then close down the gap, and therefore you'll put pressure on them. This will make it easier to tackle and possibly game possession. So like if you put pressure on them, they're going to just like mess up sometimes, and it'll be easier for you to put the ball. So as soon as you start sprinting at them, they're going to start getting worried and they might miss a turn or whatever. So the strengths towards this play, this will be a strength playing hockey. The weaknesses will be not having good speed because you won't be able to reach the correct level of play, such as like we just talked about. So obviously if you don't have that speed, they can obviously run away from you, and it can lead to them going all the way down that pitch and scoring. So the way to improve is doing frequencies 1 to 2 times per week. Intensity up to 10 seconds of working at your 90 to 100% of your best ability, because you obviously want that power, like speed going all the time. And then it's until completion, so until you finish that training set, and interval training is normally the one to go for. Lastly, our last test is the multi-stage fitness test. And your results show that you are poor, you fall into the category of poor. This means you need to improve your cardiovascular endurance. Having poor cardio means that you'll become out of breath and fatigue quicker because you won't be able to consume enough oxygen in one breath to allow the muscles to have the correct nutrients to obviously give the muscles to carry on throughout the game. So this will lead to a build-up of lactic acid because that oxygen isn't removing the CO2. So this will mean obviously the muscles become fatigued and being weakened. So this is a weakness towards hockey. Improving your cardiovascular endurance will make it a strength towards exercising because you'll be able to work for a longer period of time throughout the match. This will benefit the team as a whole because it means you can move around on the pitch, and you'll be open for the passes between like players, and so it keeps the game flowing and keeps it all like perfect. So the way you can improve this is doing cardio 3 to 5 times a day, a week. That'd be a lot. Intensity, working at a level of intensity between 7 and 9, therefore working hard throughout. 30 minutes or more. So if you wanted to improve like further, going more than 30 minutes will help you obviously. And you can either do continuous training, which is basically running for a long amount of time, or you can do fartlek training, which is speed pace, so therefore you change the pace, such as doing walking, jogging, sprinting, and the chimes can change. Thank you, Lizzie.
Got really